Dreamcatcher es un nuevo thriller que te mantendrá con los pelos de punta. Y el día de hoy se encuentra con nosotros gran parte del elenco. Chicos, ¿cómo se encuentran el día de hoy?
Hey, so good. So good. Thanks for having us.
Nikki, sabemos que tú tienes un gran papel en esta película. Quiero que me platiques qué fue lo que te inspiró y además la experiencia que viviste al participar en Dreamcatcher.
Was I just loved the concept of the movie. I thought it was fun, it was entertaining, it was sexy, and it had so many layers and so many messages. And the message that really stuck out to me was the idea of escapism and escaping your pain through making bad decisions, pretty much. And we've all been there, we've all done it, and my character in the movie does it a lot. And I just love the idea of exploring that journey of hers.
Jacob, en Dreamcatcher estamos viendo algo que no veíamos en las películas de suspenso, de horror o de un thriller. Vemos mucha inspiración de la cultura pop de los 90. ¿Qué nos dices al respecto?
We see trends in horror where, you know, there was a resurgence of the 80s and bringing back all the nostalgia of the 80s in the last probably 15, 20 years. And, you know, seeing that things are kind of shifting somewhat into a 90s direction and early 2000s, you know, the genre just continues to recycle itself in different ways. And since, you know, Crystal and Brandon and I, when we first were talking about doing this film, we're such fans of, you know, 90s genre fare, ensemble genre fare, and trying to find ways to reintroduce that to modern audiences who maybe either grew up on it like we did or haven't, as you know, been exposed to it in a certain way, so we can kind of bring that to them as well, so they can maybe look back and go, oh, I want to watch some of these 90s movies now that I've watched this.
Crystal, para ti llevar a cabo el proyecto de Dreamcatcher fue algo grandísimo. Platícanos un poco de esto y qué significa para ti.
This is the first film out of my brother is my producing partner and our new production company is called Corto Studios. And this is our first film under that new banner. And so we've collaborated with other filmmakers in the past, and this is really exciting because I feel like we're taking a leap into the unknown. And I think that that's really frightening, but it's also very exciting because I think that's where you grow the most. And I think that's where the magic lies.
Estamos ahorita en lo que es el mes de la historia de la mujer. Como mujeres en el mundo hollywoodense, ¿qué es a lo que se han enfrentado, a los retos y las experiencias que les han dejado?
In every industry, but I would say specifically in the entertainment industry, because it is such a male-dominated industry, especially behind the camera, it's important to have a lot of strong women help, I think, lead the force to opening up this idea of equality across the map.
Equality, I think it's awesome that we get to witness it and we get to continue and contribute to society nowadays. I think the landscape is completely shifting and I think it's going to continue to shift. And to be a part of that sort of decade and decades to come, I can't help but look at how wonderful everything is.
Chicos, muchísimas gracias por habernos acompañado el día de hoy. Y me gustaría invitarlos a que no se pierdan Dreamcatcher. Ya está disponible en las plataformas digitales y on demand. Nosotros vamos a continuar con más aquí en KSDY50 TV. Para la comunidad, para ti.